हेलो चिल्ड्रेन, स्टरडे आई हैड गिवन अ फ्यू क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम चैप्टर वन ऑफ स्टार्स द थर्ड लेवल। बिफोर गिविंग आंसर्स आई विल टेल यू इन ब्रीफ व्हाट इज द चैप्टर अबाउट। द थर्ड लेवल इज द अकाउंट ऑफ अ क्यूरियस एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ चार्ली। इट इज हार्ड टू बिलीव दैट देयर कैन एग्जिस्ट सच एन ओल्ड वर्ल्ड ऑर्डर इन द ट्यूब रेलवे। हिज एक्सपीरियंस cannot be suspected by any reasoning. The strange incident is not one time. Charlie visits that place quite a number of times. He travels back in imagination in the year 1894. Possibly, it was because of his stamp collecting hobby. He had in his collection the first day cover envelope. The psychiatrist tried to explain it as Charlie's desire to escape from railway through temporary. The story roughly runs and follows. Charlie, one evening, leaves his office a little later. He wants to reach home as early as possible, so he decides to travel not by bus but by train. He climbs down two levels at the Grand Central Station. There, he gets lost. He walks on and on. He hears some sound, he follows it and reaches the third level. Everything there bears the stamp of the late 19th century. The people, their dresses, the newspaper, the currency, all take him to the 19th century. The psychiatrist Sam sends him a letter of invitation dated July 18, 1894 and advises him to keep looking for the third level. So this was brief summary of this, and now I will give answer of the given questions. Question number one: what does the third level refer to? And the answer is, the third level was in fact a medium of escape for Charlie. Usually the underground railroads have only two levels, but Charlie, who was perhaps tense and worried, climbed down to the third level at the Grand Central Station. He had a feeling that he had traveled back to the year 1894. It was a journey in imagination. Question number two: the modern world is full of insecurity, fear, war, worry, and stress. What are the ways in which we attempt to overcome them? And the answer is, life in our age is full of tension and worry. There is no leisure, no peace of mind. The fear of the unknown accidents and calamities, war and diseases keeps us all on pins. How to cope with this overwhelming senses of insecurity is the real problem of today. Can a psychiatrist help us or doctors? How can physical ailments be cured? Will spiritual training or yoga and meditation give us peace of mind? No. Single factor can make us truly happy and contented. One should find the way by one's own efforts. Now, question number three. Where did Charlie and his wife Louisa want to go in 1894, and how does he visualize Galesburg town? And the answer is, Charlie and his wife asked for two tickets to Galesburg, Illinois. It is still a wonderful town. In 1894, the people sat out of their lawns, smoking and talking pleasantly. It was a peaceful world. The booking clerk, however, refused to accept the new dollar notes. He showed the author old style notes, different looking. The author walks out of the station fast. Next day, he bought old style currency at a premium. He went back to the station but could not find the third level. Now, question number four: what discovery did Charlie make while fussing with his stamp collection? The answer is, one night he found an old stamp on the envelope. It was called the first cover. A new stamp issued
in 1894, it had been mailed by someone to Charlie's grandfather who lived in Galesburg. It bore the stamp dated July 18, 1894. It bore the picture of President Garfield. Now, question number 5. What is the first takeover? Stamp collectors invariably go in for new stamps whenever they are issued. These stamps are used to mail envelopes to buyers themselves. The postmarks prove the date. The envelopes are never opened and they contain only blank papers. The envelope is called a first takeover. Now, two long answer type questions. Question number 1. What did Charlie notice at the third level of the Grand Central? Charlie lost his way at the Grand Central. Along a tunnel, he reached the third level. He noticed the old world atmosphere there as it was in 1894, a smaller room, fewer ticket windows and train gates and wooden information booths in the center. The man in the booth wore a long black sleep coat. The light was dim because of open flame gas lights. There were brass spittoons on the floor and pocket watches were common. Even the locomotive belonged to the late 19th century. The clerk demanded old-style dollars. Charles found a copy of the vault printed on June 14, 1894. The currency and bill notes were different. The vault at the third level is not real. It is the product of Charlie's mind just to lose himself in the romance and fancy of 1894 and get much needed solace and peace. Question number 2. Write a pen portrait of Charlie. Charlie is the protagonist of the story. He is 31 years old, lives in New York and is quite fashionable if one looks at his dress, but is not happy. Stark and harsh realities of the world had compelled him to lie low and remain dispirited. Charlie is romantic at heart and wants to escape from his humdrum existence. His unhappiness stems from a life and world fraught with stress, fear and war. Insecurity frightens him beyond repair. Like any mortal, he loves his wife Louisa and wants to be in her company. He wants to escape to a fairyland to enjoy life maximum. He finds the third level a fantastic world of peace, romance and dreams. He desires to live there. Charlie is an innocent person and believes that everybody wants to escape. His escapist tendency is revealed in this stamp collecting hobby, which is a route to a fantastic and peaceful past. We can simply say that Charlie is not of stable mind. It will not be wrong to say that he represents most of us. Most of us are spilled personalities. So these were the answers of the given questions. And next we shall discuss in next video. Thank you.